गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर यू हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द प्रोपोर्शनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड ऑल्सो रिजर्वेशन ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज विच वॉज डन बाय द डेलिमिटेशन कमीशन एंड इलेक्शन कमीशन इन द कोलेबोरेशन. एंड टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शन एंड मेनी अदर इलेक्टोरल रिफॉर्म्स. Our constitution makers were too much worried about the regarding election and specially free and fair election. So they provided many provisions to ensure free and fair elections. First one is universal franchise, means under this all adults, that is the person who is of age 18 years or above eligible to vote in the elections without any discrimination, Indian citizen has completed the age of 18 years, he or she is able to cast their vote. Adult franchise ensures that all citizens are able to participate in the process of voting their representatives. Second point, right to contest, means under this right, every citizen has the right to stand in the election, but there are different age requirements for contesting elections. For example, in Lok Sabha or Assembly election, a candidate must be 25 years of age, and if the person has been to jail for 2 or more years, he is disqualified from contesting elections. Mainly the age bar is important for this without any discrimination. Third provision for free and fair election is independent election commission. To ensure free and fair elections in the country, an independent election commission has been formed. As you know, election commission holds the election in India and it is independent body. In India, elections responsibility to in India, elections are held by election commission. Article 324 of the Indian Constitution provides for an independent election commission for the superintendence, direction and control of the electoral roll and the conduct of elections in India. Election Commission's presiding officer is known as Chief Election Commissioner. To assist the Election Commission of India, there is a Chief Electoral Officer in every state. The Election Commission is not responsible for the conduct of local body elections. Only national or state elections are conducted by the Election Commission. The Election Commission of India can either be a single member or a multi-member body. Till 1989, the Election Commission was a single member. Just before the 1989 general election, two election commissioners were appointed, making the body multi-member. Soon after the elections, the commission reverted to its single member status in 1993. All the commissioners are appointed by the President of India. They are appointed for 6 years or continue till the age of 65. They can be removed before the expiry on the recommendation of the Parliament. This was the composition of Election Commission and now the functions, or we can say main works done by Election Commission or Nirvachan Sadan. It supervises the preparation of up-to-date voters list. It makes every effort to ensure that the voters list is free of works. It also determines the timings of election and prepares the election schedule, which includes the dates of the registration, date of election, date of last day of registration, etc. The election commission has to ensure that the election must be free and fair. If election commission feels that the election are not happening in a fair manner, then it can postpone the election of the whole constituency. Difficulties faced by the election commission in recent times due to many reasons. The election faced many difficulties in holding elections in militancy affected areas like Assam, Punjab and Jammu Kashmir, and also for the reason of terrorism. The sudden killing of Rajiv Gandhi in 1991 caused many difficulties in way elections. The sudden dissolving of Gujarat Assembly also caused many difficulties. Election Commission faced many difficulties. In spite of that, it is doing very much good work for the democracy of India. And now the post of Chief Election Commissioner is held by Sunil Arora. Few suggestions, or we can say reforms, for the election process of Indian democracy. Our country's first one is change in the election system. Our country's election system should be changed to proportional representation from FPTP system so that the part will get seats as far as possible. Second, reservation for women. Seats should be reserved for women in the parliament. Control on money. As you know, politicians spend too much money at the time of election. The election expenses should be paid by the government to control the role of money in electoral politics. Next one suggestion is restrictions about criminal history. Some criminals also get the seats in the parliament or in the states legislative assemblies. The candidates should not be allowed to participate in the elections if they have any criminal case or any criminal background. Next, ban on the use of caste and religious appeals. Some contestants for win, they most of the time they explain many appeals to the people on the basis of religious. That is not good practice for democracy. There should be ban on using caste and religious appeals in the campaign. And next suggestion is regulation for political parties. Means certain regulations must be set by the election commission for political parties. There should be a law to keep a check on the functioning of political parties. Sometime they cross their limits. Now many new suggestions for electoral reforms. The people themselves should be careful and should actively involve in politics. Means in India, we have very much percentage of illiterate or uneducated persons. So, they don't take the real meaning of politics. So, this is very much important. People take part in the politics in a fair manner. And second, suggestions for the organizations. Various organizations should be keep a check on the elections process. All these electoral reforms are suggested for Indian democratic process. Thank you and have a nice day.